Now then, Junior, for Pete's sake, do what I tell you. I puts the corn inside the loop here, like this. She steps in to get the feed like this, and then you cut the rope.
No, no, Junior, not now!
I done a bad thing.
Hello to all my friends. Crom to one here with my friend Mo, down in the basement once again. I picked up 3 boxes of comics about a week ago, and I've finally gotten through one of them, and I thought I'd give a quick rundown of what I picked up. Got these for about $1.70 each, so I can't complain. Some really nice comics. Action Comics number 423, Superman. I got 2 copies of number 2, Amazing Adventures with the Inhumans and the Black Widow. Amazing Adventures number 3, also picked up 2 nice copies of that. Amazing Adventures number 9 with a great Magneto Black Bolt Inhumans cover. 2 copies of that as well. Some Golden Age. Animal Antics number 37 by DC. Good kids comic. Get the glare off of that a little. Got Army War Heroes, Charlton number 5. Really nice shape, that one. Number 27 featuring the Iron Corporal. Also got some Astonishing Tales, Marvel 15-cent cover, number 2, Kazar and Dr. Doom. These are actually really good reads, these ones. And number 4. I just kind of grabbed what was available when I got down there, so I got a mix of almost everything. Got Baby Huey, number 14, from the, I guess, late 50s. Good. That's actually from 1958. Got some Batman Family, nice high-grade copies, too, number 4. Number 5, number 11, really like this cover, Robin and Batgirl getting married on this cover, and Batman Family number 16. I got a nice Del 4 color, number 1029, Boots and Saddles. It was a TV show from the late 50s. I've actually shown issue number 1 of this before, but I needed issue number 2, Captain Canuck, Canadian comic, and number 3, Captain Canuck. It was fun to find those in that bargain bin. Got a movie comic, John Ford's Cheyenne Autumn, one of the movie classics, with photos of James Stewart and Ever G. Robinson and Carl Malden on the cover. Another great actor, Richard Widmark. Good cover. 50s Chip and Dale. Nice shape. A 50s Cisco Kid. Another Dell comic. I got Dennis the Menace in Hawaii. I believe that's from 1958 or 1959. Giant size 100 page issue. This was a nice find. I've been wanting this comic. Jungle Action number 5. It's actually the first Black Panther in the Jungle Action comics from the 20-cent covers in the 70s. So it was nice to pick that one up. I got a Golden Age Kerry Drake Detective Cases, number 13. I always loved Walt Disney. Got a Mickey Mouse, number 34, with a Pluto cover, and another one, number 49, also with a Pluto cover, both from the mid-50s. Got a nice high-grade copy of Mighty Marvel Western number 2, Rawhide Kid, Kid Colt, Two Gun Kid stories. I know I have the first issue, I don't think I've ever shown it, but I do have the first issue of the Mighty Marvel Western as well. And I got number 3 as well. So it's nice to pick those up. Got some Our Army at War, Sergeant Rock number 160. Good battle cover. 171. Another great cover. Sergeant Rock Fights the Mad Emperor. Got number 195. These are all 60s. One of the 100 page Super Spectaculars, number 242. And I actually got another one as well. Number 275. Our Army at War with featuring Sergeant Rock. Picked up I guess it's the 60s Our Fighting Forces, number 78. Some of these comics are a little beat up. Some are in really high grade shape, so it was a really nice mix that I got. It was fun to pick up so many different types of comics for such a great price. This was an interesting issue. It's Our Fighting Forces number 95. But what's really cool about it, it's actually the first appearance of the Fighting Devil Dog, who ends up being he's Sergeant Rock's Marine brother. You can just see that. It's Sergeant Rock's brother. He got his own few issues, I guess, in Our Fighting Forces. This is a nice high-grade Outlaws of the West. Number 17, from the late 50s. Good Western cover. For all you TV fans out there from the 70s, Partridge Family number 2. Picked up another Charlton, the Peacemaker, number 4, with the origin of the Peacemaker. 50s DC, Peter Panda, number 9. 60s Disney's The Phantom Blot meets Mad Madam Mim. Now these next ones I picked up are from the 70s, but you gotta love the covers. Plop number 2, they're all Basil Wolverton covers. He did the most strangest covers, but they're all pretty awesome. Certainly had his own style of artwork. Number 4. I got a couple of the giant size plops. So number 21. These would be from the 70s as well. And number 22 with the cool King Kong cover. Also got Porky Pig number 29. Really nice high grade copy. And for those of you who remember some of the TV westerns from the 50s, got the first issue of The Rebel. 4-color 1076 with a Nick Adams cover. So I was surprised also to find that one in the bargain bin. Also got number 1138, which is the second issue of The Rebel. And it was really cool that they had two copies, so I got two copies of it, which is really nice. Got number 2 of the Secret Society of Supervillains. Now I also got a lot of Sergeant Furies. I really do have a lot already, but these are nice to pick these up in the bargain bin. Number 32. Number 33. Number 34. All 12 cents, 60s covers. Number 48. With the Blitz Squad. Also got a couple of the specials, or you could call them annuals, but they're also the ones from specials to annuals. Same thing for Marvel, really. King Size Special number 2 from 1966, D-Day. And number 4, The Battle of the Bulge. Really cool thing about these Sergeant Fury annuals, I actually have every one. Every issue that they've right, one up to, I think it is 7. I have all of them. I got a Shadow, number 6. The great Mike Kaluta cover. This is nice to find. It's actually my second copy of Showcase Presents Angel and the Ape, the first appearance of Angel and the Ape. 4-color, 898, Max Brand Silver Tip, good Western. Nice shape. I read this one. This was an excellent read. Space Adventures from the early 60s. I don't believe I know the number offhand. I think it's like 33 or something. But it's Alan Shepard. It's the true story of the first American into space. Great issue. I really enjoyed reading that. It was really historical. Got a Spin and Marty, number 767. Del 4 color, and one of the series Spin and Marty as well. So the issue of each of those. Some Star Spangled War Stories with Enemy Ace, number 142. I got one of the 52 big pages, 162, with the Unknown Soldier. Really good issue too. I actually read this issue already. I got one of the reprint Strange Adventures 242, but it's high grade, and it's a reprint of a cover from the 60s. But I love that cover. Awesome cover. Super DC Giant number 27 with the Strange Flying Saucers Adventures. Some good stories there. I got a Super Mouse, the Big Cheese from the 50s, kids comic number 27. Tom and Jerry. From 1952, I believe, issue 101. Cover's a bit rough, but pages are all complete. It's actually pretty nice inside, and another 50s Tom and Jerry comic. I really enjoy picking these up. I really in the bargain bin because they're just awesome comics and great reads. The Tomahawks from the 60s are some great covers. The DC covers, this is number 106. Really, really love that cover. And the last one I'm going to show today, because I'm trying to keep this fairly short, is a Wilbur from 1953, number 57, which was an Archie-style comic. So, well, I hope you enjoyed seeing those comics with me, and I've got two more boxes to show, plus some other ones I've actually picked up recently from eBay. And for Mo and myself, Cromdawan, I want to thank you for taking your time to spend some time with us. So, take care. Bye for now. We'll see you again real soon.
Just act like a baby chick. Then she'll think she's your mother.
Gee whiz, my mother. I never had no mother, George.
Okay, Junior, okay. We must proceed ahead.
My mother. Hello, George.